Good day, everyone. It's time for weather news with J7409, the name you know, the news you can use. Please stick around for the entire broadcast here as I will be going over what's happening with the systems and subtropical storms and tropical storms out in the Atlantic. Before this is over, I'll show you what's going on this morning with those also. And of course, we're looking at the GFS map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. And for you guys from Montana, parts of Idaho, Wyoming, Utah, Colorado, up into North and South Dakota, parts of Nebraska, maybe Kansas, and parts of Minnesota. And then next, coming up ahead of time in the next 11 to 15 days, you guys do have a chance of getting some snow. Let's turn this on, get it going, and let you know what's happening today. Now, the heavy rainfall threat continues as we begin this week from portions of the Tennessee Valley into the Ohio Valley as plenty of moisture overrides a remnant surface boundary draped across the Mid-South and a cold front approaches from the west. Now, I want to let you know in Tennessee, about midway the state headed east, it's going to stall. This front is going to stall. There is a chance of flooding for you guys, okay? Now, it's a chance for the flash flood happening, and it's the region of the Tennessee Valley and the Ohio Valley, okay? Now, it's looking like you might even have a slight risk of some flash flooding tomorrow as well as today and tonight. Now, heavy rainfall is also possible across portions of the Mid-Atlantic northeast Monday. And that's because of this little pressure system that's coming up the coast, as we've all seen on the tropical maps from the National Hurricane Center. Now, when this happens, it should happen today and go on into tomorrow. And it's going to be a wedge of surface high pressure eroding, and it's going to allow for warm, moist air from the south to seep into the region. Now, expect scattered showers and thunderstorms to also continue this week across the southeast with an already warm and humid air mass with moderate to locally heavy rainfall possible for the coastal Carolinas by tomorrow afternoon as a wave of low pressure moves northward near the coastline. Yes, we're going to get rainfall on the coastal Carolinas tomorrow, maybe a little on Wednesday, and even more on Thursday. So we do have some rain coming. Now, an elevated to critical fire weather is still a big concern threat, and it's going to continue today across portions of the Central Great Basin, the Central Rockies, and Northern California, where the temperatures are above normal and humidity levels remain low. Red flag warnings are in effect for parts of the Northeast, Utah, Southern Wyoming, and Northwest Colorado, as well as inland Northern California. And the conditions across the Great Basin Rockies should improve by tomorrow, but an elevated risk remains for Tuesday in Northern California. Expect showers and thunderstorms to develop along a cold front as it pushes east from the plains into the upper Midwest today. Locally heavy rain is possible, particularly across the upper Mississippi Valley near a surface low drifting northeastward along the boundary. Severe thunderstorms are also possible across the Ohio Valley for tomorrow ahead of this front, and it's looking like much of the entire region, as I said earlier, is under this threat. You could have gusty winds. Don't rule out the possibility of small hail, and some of these storms will be capable of producing tornadoes. So please be aware today and tomorrow in these regions of this happening. Now, checking in with the National Hurricane Center this morning, we will start right over here. Everyone on the East Coast, don't panic. We should not have anything like we had with Florence, but we will be receiving some rain, and this is a broad area of low pressure. It's located about midway between Bermuda and the Bahamas, and it continues to produce a limited amount of showers and thunderstorm activity. Now, environmental conditions are forecast to become slightly more conducive for development during the next couple of days, while the system moves west northwestward to northwestward by tomorrow night and Wednesday. Upper level winds are expected to increase, limiting the chances for additional development while the system moves northward near the southeastern United States coast. We got 30% in 2 days, 40% in 5 days of it doing something, and it should be past us, okay? Everybody right in this area, and it should go on up. Just a big rainmaker is what it should be, folks. We really don't need a lot of rain in the Carolinas right now. And for that part, not up in Pennsylvania and parts of Virginia, nobody needs a rain, but this is a big rainmaker, and whatever we get out of this system will be rain. Now, so far as Kirk goes, Kirk is like beginning to die down a bit. Kirk has winds of 35 miles per hour this morning. The minimum central pressure is 1,007 millibars. It's located at 9.5 north, 37.4 west. Kirk is still booking, moving west at 24 miles per hour. Now, up here, we've got a situation going on. We have subtropical storm Leslie. Excuse me. Right above it, this could turn into Michael. Yep, it's looking like Michael may get stuck between the two high pressures and absorb Leslie and then turn into Michael. There's a chance of that. We'll check it out in a moment. Right now, Leslie still has winds of 40 miles per hour. Its minimum central pressure is 1,004 millibars, located at 32.6 north, 48.6 west, and movement is south at 6 miles per hour. So Leslie's not really going to go anywhere unless she gets absorbed by disturbance number two. Now, a non-tropical low pressure system is expected to form north of subtropical storm Leslie along a cold front over the central Atlantic by Wednesday. Leslie and the non-tropical low are expected to merge over the central Atlantic, where conditions appear conducive for the low to acquire tropical or subtropical characteristics by the end of the week. 2 days, zero chance, but in 5 days, we got a big old 50% chance. Will this become Michael? We'll have to wait and see. Now, listen, everybody, if you're in the Lesser Antilles area, this is all about Kirk. Well, Kirk should take a course toward the Lesser Antilles, as we've seen. And this should happen in about 3 or 4 days. And interest there should monitor the progress of Kirk, the progress of Kirk, okay? So if you live in those areas, please keep up with your local news. Although Kirk will be moving over warmer waters and remain in relatively moist conditions, its fast forward speed will likely limit the system from strengthening significantly during the next few days. So only little intensification is predicted. I'm telling you, when they move fast, they do not grow. They do not intensify like they do when they're moving slow. Now, the global models show a notable increase in westerly shear also when Kirk reaches the Eastern Caribbean Sea in about 4 days, and that should cause weakening and possibly even dissipation by the end of the forecast period. Now, the National Hurricane Intensity Forecast lies near the lower side of the guidance envelope in best agreement with the NOAA HCCA model. And you can see the days coming up ahead: 35, 35, 40, 40, 45, 45, 40, 35. That's your winds right there. Nothing that you guys can't handle. It will be a little inconvenient with some, maybe possibly a little higher gusts once in a while, but it's going to die on down, and you will get some rain, so be aware of that. And as we look at the tracking map from the National Hurricane Center, you can see it's down to a depression right now. It's going to stay that way for the most part today. But by in the early morning hours, around 2 a.m. tomorrow, it should turn back into a tropical storm and remain that way as it approaches the islands and gets closer to them, actually going across them around 2 a.m. on Friday. Once it crosses over, it's back down to a depression just south of Puerto Rico, down south of the Dominican Republic, and it should just diminish and decay on away. So, everybody up in this area, you see where the cone is. I'm still thinking it may move up just a little from this, but right in this area, anywhere in this area, if you live there, be prepared for a tropical storm coming your way. Okay, here we have a look at the GFS sea level pressure map. It goes through the next 384 hours. You can see this a little better. It's from my Fox Hurricane. All right, big old high pressure, right? We got a big old low pressure up here and another high pressure here. But these are the two that we're concerned with. This is Leslie right here. And this is a little system that's going to bring rain all the way up to Pennsylvania, Carolina coast, and on out. So let's click it across and see if Michael forms. Here we go. We're going to move it right along. It's wedged right in between those high pressure systems. You can see how they are beginning to go together. This would be the formation of Michael. This is Leslie here, still just kind of pinched between these two high pressures. Let's see what happens as we run it on through. And once again, this is the GFS. You can see them merging together now. This is around 50 to 60 hours out. The isobars begin to tighten up, and yeah, we got Michael. It's looking like. Looks like we have Michael. Looks like it stays Michael for a while. Isobars start to loosen up a little bit. Now we've got to wait till this comes back on and refreshes people. Okay, let's try this again right quick and see if it will work for us any better here. Well, it just doesn't want. Here we go. Now we're moving along. Look at that thing go. Stay away from the East Coast. Now it's getting wedged again. This is around 180 hours out. Looking like the low up above is going to try to work its way up and pull it out, but it's not going to make it because the high pressure will go across it again. But after 252 hours out, it looks like it passes. Well, look at that. We have another one come right off the coast and form. This would be Nadine. I mean, we're going through the alphabet, huh? We're still watching Michael. If this were to look like it's going to with the GFS model, this would be Nadine. The high pressures are keeping them down. Would you look at that? Now we got, okay, Michael's just about gone down to nothing. Then this would be Nadine. I'd have to look up this name for this one. I'm not quite sure. That looks just like a low pressure system for right now, though. It's not a big bad storm. And here we go. More low pressures coming up. So now let's go check out the European model. Okay, we're over the European model now. Here is Leslie right here. This, of course, is what's left of Kirk this morning, but Kirk will come back up a little bit as it goes across. So you can see the date. Today's the date, the 24th of September, Monday, of course, 2018. We will move it along and let's see what the European model shows us. It shows that Leslie does try to tighten up and form just like the GFS shows it. We see it trying to go up in that wedge. There it is in the wedge. There you go, right there, trying to be absorbed by the other system. This is on the 4th of October, and that's as far as it goes. It doesn't go as far, of course, as the GFS, and that's a little far out to actually tell. But here we go to the 4th of October. You can see that is about when they are going to, this system will be absorbed, and we will see if Michael is born. This system that comes off the coast here, that's the next one. We'll see what happens with it. If it were to form like the GFS is showing, that would be Nadine. But right now, we're going to see if Michael does form and just kind of soaks up Leslie. So, with that all said, we got lots to watch, all my friends down in the islands. Prepare yourself for a tropical storm, a low-end tropical storm, not a high-end tropical storm. But you will get rain, you will get gust of winds, you will have flooding probably in places. So please be aware of that. Everybody else, keep your eyes on Leslie. See if Michael forms. I think it will. Either Michael will absorb Leslie, or Leslie will absorb Michael. And also, we have to watch over here to see if Nadine is born. And that's the weather today. Please subscribe, my friends. Click the bell. Check off the email notifications to make sure you get all the latest in weather news, forecasts, watches, warnings, and tropical weather. I love you guys so much. Thanks for the likes, the comments, every single thing you do for me. I just love you so much. You have a good day, a blessed day. Peace, love, and kindness to all, and thanks for watching.